Mexican gray wolves are the most endangered subspecies of gray wolf here in North America, and trying to restore them should be a very high priority. Zana and Flint were carefully matched to each other through genetic matchmaking, and so we know that their offspring will be valuable for both the zoo population and also for the recovery and reintroduction program. We started out with just slowly introducing them through a fence line. And then once we were sure they seemed compatible, they were introduced to each other and have been on exhibit since then.
So today was the first day that we allowed the wolves to come on to their actual exhibit, and Flint was the first to come out.
Oh, there he is. I can see him.
And then the very first thing he did was check out the entire exhibit.
I think they look gorgeous in the snow.
Initially, they just watched each other and sort of avoided each other. And now as the keepers approach, sometimes they do see them laying close together. But as we get closer, they tend to separate.
Well, wolves are very curious by nature. I think it's part of what they need in order to succeed in the wild. So if they see a camera or something different in their environment, they will seek it out and investigate it. And we see that sort of behavior all the time here. All of these wolves are kept in their wild state. So you do see them replicate some of the behaviors that wild wolves would show. You'll often see the male patrolling around the edge of the exhibit, and that's normal roaming behavior that you would see in the wild. We do not do any sort of positive reinforcement training with them. We don't interact with them, so that they stay wild and they don't become trained wolves or wolves that wouldn't be appropriate for the reintroduction program.
They tend to spend most of their time resting, and they tend to pick the places that are high. We have one quite tall mound in the exhibit, and that's typically where every pack we've had in the past tends to lay because they get such a good view of the surrounding area. Just because we put a male and a female together doesn't guarantee that these two are actually going to court and develop a relationship. Some of the things that the keepers and the managers of the wolves that we're going to be looking for is how much time they spend together. Are they sleeping together? Do they patrol the exhibit together? That's basically how we'll discern whether or not we feel they're a successful pairing. They're still very secretive and working on their relationship, I would say.